coming to you today from some of the beautiful area that surrounds our church here at Newton First Assembly of God, the Life Church of the Wiregrass. And we wanted to show you some of the surroundings as we promised we would do. And we're talking about Waiting on God from Andrew Murray's book, devotional by that name. We've reached chapter number 10. And I want to finish it off today, and then we'll begin with chapter 11 tomorrow. The scripture text, and I must add this, that we're also using Sherilyn Sidebottom's study guide, which she has prepared for our church as she has been teaching on this subject. And so I'm drawing a lot from that, and you can receive that if you want to go to their website, walkwithmeministries.net, and order the study guides directly from her, Sherilyn Sidebottom's study guide of waiting on God. And we're looking at Psalms 33, and one of the areas that we were talking about over the last couple of days had to do with humble fear and hope. And I left you at our last study, we were talking about what God wants to do in our lives by elevating us. And let me just share with you one of the quotes. The lower we bow, the deeper we become in the knowledge of God. The lower we bow, the nearer we are to God. That is totally and completely upside down in a world today that says exalt yourself, have tremendous self-pride, and all of those things about how our society tells us to gain and to be above. But in the kingdom of God, it's upside down. If we want to go higher, then we make ourselves lower. If we want to gain, there are things we're gonna lose. But God is the restorer of all things. And He wants to restore all things lost that have been lost for His sake. Can you capture that? Even in life itself, when we lose this life, hallelujah, we gain eternal life. Not only in Christ, but forever with Christ. We'll be back tomorrow with chapter 11. Stay tuned in to YouTube at NewtonFirstAssembly.org. Just click on that daily devotional. We love you guys. Pray for us as we pray for you.